What is mythological event? Now, don't underestimate the power of mythology. Mythology means a narrative, a storytelling that you invoke in order to pass on some subtle ideas into society. So mythology is not a minor thing. Every subject has got some myth. You may be surprised. Look, I'm a physicist, study physics, quantum mechanics, and I'm telling you, even physics is a bit of a myth. It's a narrative you create to understand the nature of reality. So you say, oh yes, gravity, two lumps of matter attract each other, and the attraction depends on the distance between them and the mass and blah, blah. It's a narrative you create to understand the reality in front of you. It's a narrative. You may say this reality is not reality. So soon we find that that narrative was changed by Einstein saying, no, there's no such thing. Just curvature of space-time that produces what is called gravity. Not two lumps of matter saying, hello, I like you, come here. So you see a change of narrative. Even in physics narrative, you may be surprised. Even the idea of atoms, and this is a narrative we use to understand nature of reality. So don't underestimate the power of narrative. You need some kind of a story to hang on to understand deeper reality or subtle reality. So in the Hindu tradition and in other traditions too, there are some narratives which are purely, if you don't have a historic foundation in it, they are crucial and important to understand reality. Now the second celebration that we are now undergoing at the moment is a celebration of Navaratri. Navaratri literally means nine nights. What are we celebrating? The only religion in the world that celebrates the idea of the ultimate reality, the final thing, is female, is the Hindu religion. No other religion gives that dignity to womankind. So only in the Hindu tradition you have this idea that the ultimate reality can be thought of as a female. So the nine nights are to celebrate the idea of God, not as a man with a beard and all that, but God is female. And the word we use, the general term we use is Shakti, power, strength, force. The idea is that this manifestation you see in front of your eyes, this creation, has requires some force to put it into motion. And that force we call Shakti, force, and we call it female. So the nine nights are to celebrate the idea of God, ultimate reality, as female, Shakti. This is what nine nights celebrate. And you see, you may think, well, this is an old idea. It's quite modern as well. You may have seen the Star Wars films, and you see this lovely phrase coming through. May the force be with you, Luke. You may think, oh, this is a modern idea. It's not a modern idea. It's a very ancient idea, and they have borrowed it from the Hindu mythology. It's saying, may the Mother Goddess help you. This is what he's saying. May Shakti be with you. So when you say, may the force be with you, they are talking about pure Hinduism, the idea of God as female, as power, empowering. Now how do we celebrate it? The first three nights of the Navaratri, Navaratri festival means celebrating nine nights. The first three nights we celebrate the idea of invoking energy, strength and force in us. So we celebrate the idea of God as Durga, the one who gives strength, who gives vitality, who empowers us. So the first three nights are devoted to Durga. The second three nights are devoted to the important other human aspiration. And the human aspiration is, we want to become well-to-do. Look, nothing, Hinduism doesn't say you must become poor. It's not wed to poverty. It likes what Cameron said once, wealth is not an ugly word. So with the second portion of three nights is to celebrate the idea of invoking wealth, invoking beauty and wealth. And this is personified as Lakshmi, the one who kind of allows us to create wealth and who offers beauty or aesthetics in society. So this is the second three portions are devoted to Lakshmi. First three to Durga. The final three nights are something that is more relevant for students like you. The final three nights are dedicated to the idea of invoking knowledge. And the personification of that is Saraswati. So the final three nights are celebrating the idea of God as Saraswati, as female, the one who gives knowledge. Not only knowledge, it gives us, if you like, idea of aesthetics. So if, for example, you like art, you like music, you like dance, you like drama, you like poetry, you like literature, all these are aesthetics, wonderful human aspirations. So the last three nights are dedicated to the idea of invoking aesthetics in our society. So Saraswati is worshipped on these three nights, the final three nights. The mythological story is that, okay, this is a mythological story, the mother goddess had to come down to earth and demolish a demon, a horrible monster, there are always demons in every story, including Star Wars. To demolish this demon, the mother goddess to take on a form and fight the demon for nine nights. So we are celebrating those nine nights. On the 10th night, she wins, and it's called Dashera. when you say the mother goddess or the good or evil. But this is the mythological part. What is the philosophic part of this story? Most Hindus don't know that. The philosophic aspect of this particular tradition is this. It is saying it's not pure to fight some external demon. The real demon that we need to fight, all of us, all of humanity, is within us. You say, well, how did we get that? It's not because we are villains, we are horrible monsters, and there are some horrible things in us. As we have gone through the animal kingdom, we have acquired a lot of animal characteristics, traits, because we agree with Darwin, we come out of the animal kingdom. So a lot of traits that we acquire in the animal kingdom continue to be in with us when we are in the human kingdom. And what are these attributes that we are somehow dangerous? Things like greed, lust, anger, jealousy, pride. All these things we have acquired from the animal kingdom. For example, in the animal kingdom, food was scarce. So when we come to the human kingdom, we say, food is available. So we overeat and we kind of mass more things than we require. It turns into greed. So most of these things that we have to fight against is not because we are intrinsically evil, but we acquired certain traits while we pass through the animal stage into the human. We agree with Darwin, he came out of the animals into the human. And that is why many of the faces of the Hindu gods and goddesses, you might say, why are they celebrating the elephant? We are just dignifying the animal kingdom through those colorful narratives. So this idea of, in a way, invoking or trying to fight the demons within is not something saying you're villainous inside and you need to kind of conquer it. It is something that we acquire in the animal kingdom, we don't require in the human kingdom. So we need to kind of overcome it. So the nine knights are to overcome the inner demons, like pride, jealousy, anger, lust, greed. So this is, if you like, the deeper idea of Navaratri, the nine nights of celebrating. And the key feature is, in order for you to succeed in anything in life, you need to invoke strength, shakti, power. May the force be with you. That's what it celebrates. So I'm talking about Navaratri, Diwali. Now, Navaratri says a mythological fact. I mean, I don't think Mother Goddess came down to earth and actually fought a demon. But it's a colorful narrative that allows us to think of a deeper idea. So this is, if you like, the mythological way of celebrating festivals.